Psalm 28, I will exalt you. under Psalm 86's foundations.
Themselves, the moment holy, 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 the holy gospel according to St. John, and his blessings be with us all. Amen. Glory be to God forever. Amen. May the saying of God be fulfilled in peace. The worship of Christ our God and the Father and the Holy Spirit for my heart. As let us have mercy on us. Your Holy Spirit, O Lord, whom you sent forth upon your holy disciples and your honored apostles at the third hour, do not take away from us, O God, but renew them within us, creating me and love, O God, and renew our spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. And do not take your Holy Spirit away from me, so tell me. O Lord, to send down your Holy Spirit upon your holy disciples and your honored apostles at the third hour, do not take him away from us, O good one, but we ask you to renew him within us, O Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, the world, a right, a life-giving spirit, a spirit of truth and chastity, a spirit of all this righteousness and authority, O the Almighty One. For you are the light of our souls, O you give light to every man that comes in the world. Have mercy on us. O Theotokos, you are the true vine, who bore the cluster of life. We ask you for grace with the apostles, for the salvation of our souls. Blessed be the Lord our God, blessed be the Lord day by day. He prepares our way for his God of our salvation.
Yeah.
So Lord, make us worthy to pay thanks to our Father who art in heaven. Hail to you, we ask you, sin full of glory. Holy, 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 the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew, may his blessings be with us all. Amen.
Our God, for not for more of your value, is to be lifted up off the cross.
Apostolic Orthodox Church of Latvia, remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly reward.
Pray for this holy and precious gift, our
sacrifice, that those who bring them,
Lord, have mercy.
Alleluia, by the leader who is by his choices, amen. My intelligence and all of them on him feed. Oil choice again, amen. Oil choice again, so then and more. It is my Lord in Jenny, as in your head around.
If not, if you'll be part of Krator. Fismara ut in Jib, if monogamies in Chiri Isus, be Christus ben choice. Fismara ut in Jib, if my soul be Paraclito. If not, if you take a choice, open not, open so dear Jesus, be a Christos. J of Eris, Kipazi, Nigon, Fervoitin Eron, of Arid Eron, of Shoptin Eron, of Tiasu Eron, of Titotin, of Intitcha, Eri, Etai, Omosai, and so on, Marenti, who Eron, who Pos, and Tif Arid Eron, Kempai, Eros, Rufai, Namely, in a hotel on table month, can hear in the van and jab him on the crater, so I spend no. Concerning everything and in everything, for you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
May the God be have mercy and compassion on us, hear us, help us, and accept the supplications and prayers. Bye.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with you, all fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest. Take them away from us. And from this table, and from this your holy place, but those things which are good and profitable, do provide for us, for it is you have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and upon all the power of the enemy.
Yeah. teacher Paul to the Hebrews, may his holy blessings be with us and live. Therefore, brethren, have boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh. And having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed away with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, by exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. For if we sin willfully, after we have received the knowledge of truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful expectation of judgment and fiery indignation which will devour the adversaries. Anyone who has rejected Moses' law dies without mercy on the testimony of two or three witnesses. Of how much worse punishment do you suppose will he be thought worthy who has trampled the Son of God underfoot? Counted the blood of the covenant by which he has sacrificed a common thing, and insulted the Spirit of grace? For we know who said, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord, and again, the Lord will judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, but recall the former days in which, after you were illuminated, you endured a great struggle with sufferings, partly with you, while you were made a spectacle, both by reproaches and tribulations, and partly while you became companions of those who were so treated. For you have compassion on me in my chains, and joyfully accepted the plundering of your goods, knowing that you have a better and enduring possession for yourselves in heaven. Therefore, do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward, for you have need of endurance, so that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by the faith, but if anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in the grace of God the Father, be with you all.
The Catholic epistle from the first epistle of our teacher Peter, may his holy blessing be with us, amen. For this reason, the gospel was preached also to those who are dead, that they might be judged according to man in the flesh, but live according to God in the Spirit. But the end of all things is at hand, therefore be serious and watchful in your prayers, and above all things have fervent love for one another, for love will cover a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without grumbling, as each one has received the gift. Minister it to one another as good steward of the manifold grace of God. If anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God. If anyone ministers, let him do it as with the ability which God supplies, that in all things God may be glorified through Christ, through Jesus Christ, to whom belong the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange things happen to you, but rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's suffering, that when his glory is revealed, you may also be glad with exceeding joy. If you are reproached for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. On their part, he is placed shame. Blasphemed, but on your part he is glorified. Do not love the world or the things of the world. The world is passing away and is lost, but he who does the will of God abides forever. Amen.
Yeah.
through this element. Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found any who were of the way, whether men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. As he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" And he said, "Who are you, Lord?" Then the Lord said, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goads." So he, trembling and astonished, said, "Lord, what do you want me to do?" Then the Lord said to him, "Arise and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." And the men who journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no one. Then Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no one. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And he was 3 days without sight, and neither ate nor drank. Now there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him the Lord said in a vision, "Ananias." And he said, "Here I am, Lord." So the Lord said to him, "Arise and go to the street called Straight, and inquire at the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus, for behold, he is praying. And in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him, so that he might receive his sight." Then Ananias answered, "Lord, I've heard of him from many about this man, and how much harm he has done to your saints in Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priests to bind all who call on your name." But the Lord said to him, "Go, for he is the chosen vessel of mine to bear my name before Gentiles, kings, and the children of Israel. For I will show him how many things he must suffer for my name's sake." And Ananias went his way and entered the house, and laying his hands on him, he said, "Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road as you came, has sent me that you may receive your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately there fell from his eyes something like scales, and he received his sight at once, and he arose and was baptized. So when he received food, he was strengthened, and Saul spent some days with the disciples at Damascus. Immediately he preached the Christ in the synagogues that he is the Son of God. The word of the Lord shall grow and multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
Oh.
See.
have desire to see the things which you see and have not seen, the man to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as you desire your eyes for me, see and your ears for me, hear me, and your need to hear and time according to your holy gospel, through the prayers of you.
Oh.
also in me, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am there, you may be also, and where I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on you know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and it is sufficient for us. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you so long, and yet you have not known me, Philip? He who has seen me has seen the Father. So how can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me does the works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the sake of the works themselves.
Glory to God forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Before the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, he told the disciples that he will leave them and go to the Father. So the disciples, after living 3 years with our Lord Jesus Christ, became troubled that he was their safety, he was their refuge. In any problem, in any trouble, they used to go to him and find peace and find joy. So they were troubled. That's why the Lord comforted them and told them, Do not be troubled. I will be with you unto the end of the ages, and I will send you the Holy Spirit. And since this Thursday we will celebrate the Feast of Ascension, so the Lord chose this passage from the Gospel of St. John to give us the same message that the Lord gave to the disciples when he told them about his ascension. And he told them, I am going to the Father. I'm going to prepare a place for you. And once I prepare the place, I will come and take you with me. So where I am, you will be also. And when we think about what did he mean by preparing a place, for example, if you have a guest coming to your house, you try to prepare a place for this guest and he clean the house, make it nice. So when the Lord said, I go to prepare a place for you, did he mean it in the same way as we are saying right now, or not? Definitely not. Then what did he mean by he is going to prepare a place for us? The heaven of heavens, no human nature can enter there. Actually, in the fraction of Bright Saturday, we say about the Lord Jesus Christ, he went within the veil to the holy place of the holies. So he ascended to the heaven of heavens. That's what we call it, the holy of the holies. And the fraction continues and says, the place into which anyone of human nature cannot enter. So any human nature cannot enter into the heaven of heavens. Cannot. And that's what the fraction of Bright Saturdays explain, the place into which anyone of human nature cannot enter. God the Father sent his Son, who is begotten from the Father before all ages, but in the fullness of time, he took our humanity, our full humanity. So Jesus Christ is God incarnate. Since he is the Son of the Father, he has the right to enter into the Holy of the Holies, because he is God. But now in his ascension, he will ascend with our human nature. So although this place human nature cannot enter, human being cannot go, but the Son, since he is God, he can enter into the heaven of heavens. But now he will enter with our human nature. He will enter with our human nature. So, if we abide in him and we become one in him, then in him we can enter into the place into which anyone of human nature cannot enter. So we have access to heaven only if we abide in the Son, if we become one with the Son. Otherwise, we cannot enter the heaven. So when he said, I am going to prepare a place, doesn't mean just he's going to prepare a place in the same sense when we have a guest and you prepare a place for this guest. No, it doesn't mean this. That's why he said, if you think about a place, no, in my Father's house many mansions. Don't worry about place. But preparing a place means I will enter with the human nature, with the humanity, into this place into which no humanity can enter, so you can have access in me, only in me, to enter into the heavens. That's why Thomas told him, we do not know where are you going, and we do not know the way. He told them, I am the way. What does it mean, I am the way? He explained, no one can come to the Father except through me. The only way to come to the Father and the only way to enter into the heaven is in Jesus Christ. That's why he said, I am the way. I am the way and the life and the truth. Meaning what?
by the way, if you follow the faith, you will go to heaven. But let me ask, let me challenge them. Can anyone of these relations enter into the place in which no human nature is allowed? None of them. Then they are deceivers. They are liars. They cannot actually take you to heaven. The only one who can take you to heaven, the only one who can take you to the eternal life is Jesus. That's why he said, I am the way and the life. The way and the life. Anyone else who claims that he can take you to heaven, that's falsehood. But the only one who can take you to heaven, the true one can take you to heaven, is Jesus. That's why he said, I am the truth. So, when he said, I am the way, the life, and truth, meaning what? I am the true way that leads to life. I am the only true way that leads to life. If you abide in me and I in you, also I am in the Father, as he said to Philip, when the Philip told him, show us the Father and it is sufficient. He told him, who has seen me has seen the Father. I am in the Father and the Father is in me. So Jesus is in the Father and the Father is in him. And we are in Jesus and Jesus is in us. Then, through Jesus, we can go to the Father and we can enter the Holy of the Holies, the heavens into which no one with human nature is allowed to enter. So now we understand what the Lord meant when he said, I am the way. I will go to prepare a place. But this way has certain characteristics. When the Lord explained in the Gospel of Matthew, there are two ways, a difficult way and a broad way. The difficult way is the way that leads to eternal life. Why he called it difficult? And how we can enter into this difficult way if we want to go to eternal life? He told us, number one, the gate is narrow. The gate is narrow. And narrow, both in the width and in the height. That's why if you visit old monasteries, and you visit the old cells in these monasteries, you will find the door to the cell is in its narrow, in its width, and in its height also. The only way to enter, you need to bow in order to enter. Meaning what? Meaning you need to deny yourself. You need to die completely and to live to Christ, as St. Paul said. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And this, by the way, the first requirement of discipleship. If you want to be my disciple, deny yourself. So in order to enter into this way, Jesus, to abide in him, the first requirement to enter through this narrow gate, which means complete self-denial. You have no will. Your will be his will. What do you want me, God, to do? That's complete self-denial. You have no desire. You have no ambition, or you have no thing you want to achieve except to be Christ.
Christ. Every ambition, every desire should be consecrated in your desire to be one with the Lord. That's why St. Paul said in his letter to the Philippians, whatever gain I had, I lost it all, and I consider it rubbish in order to find Christ and be found in Him, to be found in Him, to find the meaning of my life in Him. That is the key. But he said also the way itself is difficult. Jesus Christ lived his life persecuted, has no place to rest his head. At the end, he was crucified. The Lord said, if you want to be my disciple, deny yourself, and number two, carry your cross. To stay away from the pleasures of the world. As St. Paul said, those who are Christ's crucify their bodies and their desires. So the Lord did not promise us an easy way, but a difficult way in which we need to be disciplined in order to reach eternal life. It is a difficult way, but it is full of joy and peace. On the other side, the broad way, who has a wide gate. Wide gate means you can come with all your desires, with all your dreams. And in the broad way, no restrictions, no commands, nothing. You can do whatever you want to do. But at the end, these people are miserable. These people suffer from psychological issues. These people suffer from suicide because you don't have peace, joy. You cannot find peace and joy except in Christ. I'm not speaking about psychological illness here. But I'm speaking about people who live totally to the world. But when you live with Christ, yes, you will carry your cross. But the Holy Spirit will comfort you, will give you His peace, and will give you the joy that surpasses your understanding. We read in the book of Acts how the disciples were beaten, but they returned joyful because they were counted worthy to suffer for His name. In the prison, we heard about Paul and Silas were singing and chanting. How Peter was in deep sleep while he is in prison, and the following day, Herod was planning to present him to be killed. But he was in deep sleep. Yes. The way is difficult, but the comfort and the consolation and the peace and the joy of the Holy Spirit will fill your heart. This way, only few walk in it. That's what the Lord said. Unfortunately, many of those who live in the world, they are following the prince of the world, Satan. But only those who are following Christ are few. So Satan nowadays is trying to doubt, to cast doubt in our hearts, because those who are walking in the true way are few. And I will tell you, do you think the rest of the world will perish? Actually, the Bible gives us many examples how only 8 persons during the time of Noah were saved. So don't be deceived by the number. make sure that one of the signs of the true way, that only few are walking in this way. But what's beautiful about this way? Yes, it is temporary. All this difficulty, all the cross and the self-denial during our journey here on earth for a few years. But this way will end in eternal life. When we enter the place into which no human nature can enter. And in the eternal life, we will enjoy the eternity with the Holy Trinity and with all the angels and the saints. Christ is the way, and he is the head of the church. He is the head, and the church is his body. So how do you know whether you are in the true way or not? If the body of Christ is the church, then if you are in the church, you are in Christ. If you are outside the church, you are not in Christ. And in the church, both physically and spiritually. Physically, you are an active member in the church. You come to worship, to the services in the church, you serve in the church, you are an active member. But physically alone is not enough. Because some people, they are physically in the church, but their heart, they're very far from God. Like the scribes and Pharisees in the Old Testament. They were physically in the temple, but they are totally away from God. And the Lord called to this worship this vain worship. He said, these people worship me with their lips, but their hearts very far from me. That's why I said both physically and spiritually. You need to be connected with Christ. You need to have a relation with the Holy Trinity. From your heart, from your spirit. That's why the Lord said, the true worshippers are those who worship Him in spirit and truth. Being just physically in the church every Sunday, but the rest of the week, or all your life away from Christ and away from God, this will not save you. You need to be connected with the Holy Trinity. So if I am in the church, I am in Christ. I am in the true way that leads to eternal life. So today, the fifth Sunday of the Holy 50 days, and the journey, you know, we were dead. But Jesus, by his resurrection, gave us new life. This new life, the church speaks to us during the Holy 50 days. It starts with our faith in Christ, to believe in Him, first Sunday. Second Sunday, our food is His holy body and His precious blood. Third Sunday, the water, the living water, the Holy Spirit. Fourth Sunday, the light that will guide us in our journey. That is the Holy Scripture, the Word of God. And today, the way, which way we should take Jesus Christ Himself to be in the church, His body, and thus your abiding in Christ. We thank God that He came and took our humanity in order to give us access to this place into which no human nature can enter. If you think about it, it's a very, very gracious gift. We are not worthy of it. To give us access and entrance and dwelling eternally in this place where we should not be. If you think about this, actually, we will praise God for this only the rest of our life and all eternal life, the rest of glory be to him forever and ever. Amen.
As a vision of the village of women, of the great city of Alexandria, and his brother in the apostolic liturgy, the patriarch of Antioch, Mario Matz Abraham, and the patriarch of Eritrea, Abun Antonius, and his partner in the apostolic liturgy, our father, the bishop, Abba Youssef, and for our Orthodox bishop.
According to your own blessed will, grant them in order to which have been due to righteousness, and all the Orthodox bishops, dignity, priests, and deacons, and all the principles of your mom, all the holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, grant them and us this message in every place, their prayer which they offer on our behalf. As well as our on the earth, receive them on your holy Russian altar in heaven as a sweet savor of incense. All beneath visible and invisible, trembling and humiliate under their feet speedily. As for them, keep them in peace and righteousness in your holy.
Ah. your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. You have filled it with a peace by which those who glorify you sing glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth and goodwill to us, men.
Amen. With those who through the ages have pleased you, for you are a God who holds mercy and kindness, and to you is your glory, honor, and adoration from all, O Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now and forever, and the age of all ages. Amen.
Kyrie
eleison, God rich in his gifts, who have granted orders to your church and established grace of ministry to it, and poured out your gifts on your servants, sanctify these your servants also, and appoint them as leaders, and make them worthy with all wisdom and understanding to perform the meditation and reading of divine words, and fill them with your gift, while they are preserved in blameless conduct by the mercies of your only begotten Son, through whom and with whom glory, honor, and dominion are due to you, with your good life-giving and consubstantial Holy Spirit, now and forever, and the age of all ages. Amen. And loving God, in whose hands all things are held, and by whose command all things are controlled, who are near to all and stand by all, look upon this your servant, who is presented by us to be a proclaimer of your holy words of the Old and New Testament, that they may expound to the people your holy words and your right precepts, and proclaim your divine and salutary doctrines, which you have appointed for the help and salvation of our souls. O God, instruct them in your commandments, and make them understand your justification, and illuminate the eyes of their mind to the light of the knowledge of your commandments, and grant to them that with purity of heart and unfeigned faith, they may perform their meditations and readings for the upbuilding of those who hear to the praise and glory of your kingdom, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and the age of ages. Amen. Our Master and Lord God Almighty, who knew from the very number of his elect in the whole world, and who called them from the first, who chose his grace, your servant, you give him wisdom that he may lead your law to your people. You have now chosen your servants who are designated leaders. Give them wisdom and a spirit of prophecy that they may perform the practice of your holy words for your people whose blameless conduct in the grace and compassion of your only begotten Son, our Lord and our God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Remember at all times the word of the Lord, which said, that him who reads understands, so that through your good progress and your advancement in this realm, your words might therefore be seen, and you might be given approval to be advanced to the higher realm. Therefore, this is so, that those who have brought you into the midst might have a boast that they did well to give you a vote of approval at the proper time and order in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Oh. Yeah.
apostle saying, take heed of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true. Amen.
Likewise also the cup after supper, he mixed it of wine and water, and when he had given it thanks,
God in fear and trembling.
into his holy body.
I believe.
This cup also the precious blood of his new covenant.
Again I believe.
And eternal life to those who partake
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church, O God.
Lord, have mercy.
Looks like you have acquired yourself with the precious love of Christ, even peace with all Orthodox Pashons. Foremost, remember, O Lord, our blessed and honored father, the Archbishop, our patriarch, Baba Theodorus II, and his spiritual brother in the patriarch of Antioch, Maria Ramses II, but patriarch of Antioch, and Abuna Antonius, patriarch of Eritrea, and his partner in the apostolic ministry, our father, the Bishop
and his brethren, the apostolic liturgy, the patriarch of Antioch, Ordinations, and from the second, and the patriarch of Eritrea, Antonius the first, and his partner, the apostolic liturgy, our father, the bishop of Youssef, and fourth Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord.
Bless the crown of the year with your goodness for the sake of the poor, your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, for the sake of all of us who entreat you and seek your holy name. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you have given them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness that we have sufficient everything we have on every good
deed.
Remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly reward.
Pray for these holy, precious gifts, our sacrifices, and those who bring them.
Lord, have mercy.
It is a choice of us, and he bent it, because of Disciple, my Lord's Roman Father, send me. whom the Kenonia and the Lord his disciple, our father Abba Shimon, his archmandrite, and Abba Yisuf, his disciple, and all the choir of your sacred prayer supplications, have mercy on us all, and save us for the sake of your holy name, which is called upon us.
Those whom each one of us has in mind, and those who are not in mind, who have fallen asleep and repose in the faith of Christ, graciously accord, O Lord, to remember the soul of your servants. Remember these.
Pray for our fathers and brethren who have fallen asleep and repose in the faith of Christ since the beginning. Our holy fathers, the archbishops, our fathers, the bishops, our fathers, the hegemons, our fathers, the priests, our brethren, the deacons, our fathers, the monks, and our fathers, the laymen, and for the full repose of Christians, that Christ our God may repose all their souls in the paradise of joy, and we too accord mercy unto us, and forgive us our sins.
Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, sustain them in green pasture beside still waters in the paradise of joy, the place out of which grief, sorrow, and groaning have fled away in the light of your sin.
May their holy blessing be with us. Amen.
The Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus.
For he also has made us worthy now to stand in this holy place, to lift up our hands and to serve his holy name. Let us also ask him to make us worthy of the communion and partaking of his divine and immortal mysteries.
Amen.
Peace, O Maestro.
Give us our be the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Sanctification is by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
One is the Holy Father, one is the Holy Son.
Concerning them, remember us.